give up asking and requesting. Even if God has not answered yet, keep on asking. Keep on praying. Your answer will be here in due time.
Here, Aunt Clara. A nice cup of tea will make you feel better.
Oh, little one.
If you want to change, start with your thinking.
That's what Mandel sings.
Your mind is a reflective tool given to you by God for your advancement and transformation in life. It is intangible, yet highly potent. And setting the structure of men, we see that we are spirit, living in body, and each one of us has a soul. The body is tangible, but the spirit is intangible. The brain helps our physical body to function effectively, and the mind enables our spirit to operate effectively. The mind is the gateway to the heart of man. That is why you must take care of your mind and manage it to conform to God's word and His way. Whatever you allow in your mind will ultimately be seen in your life. The way you carry yourself and the way you speak, you are not indifferent from what is in your mind. That is why the Bible says that as a man thinketh, so is he. You are the exact reflection of your mind. We know that the mind is responsible for creativity, reasoning, thought patterns, cognitive functions, and even perception. All these put together will determine the quality of life that you are going to live. If your mind leans towards the negative things of life, we will see in your life. You will live a life that is full of struggle and continually moving from grass to grass instead of grace to grace. Many people, including God's children, do not understand the value of the mind and the importance of guarding it. It is a sad thing to know that the devil knows this, and that is why he uses our mind to fight us. He drops thoughts, ideas, and pictures in our mind to see limitations, to see impossibilities, and everything wrong with life. The devil knows that once these thoughts are in our mind, they will get to our spirit. Since the spiritual realm controls the physical realm, we will see the results of darkness in the physical realm. After the fall of the first Adam, man became predisposed to take heed to the counsel of the devil. That is why it is so easy for a man to see limitations and to yield to them than it is to see possibilities. That is why it is easy for a man to live in anger and bitterness instead of forgiveness. And that is the reason why. That is the reason why it is easy to imagine the worst than it is to imagine the best in every circumstance. One of the reasons salvation is beneficial to you is that it gives you a chance to change everything about your life. If it is something unpleasant, you can turn it around. And if it's a good thing, you can make it 1,000 times better. In God, that nature in man that inclines his mind towards the negative is taken out, leaving us with an exceptional ability to lean towards the desirable thing willingly. You see, God understands the power of the human mind.